Hey guys, it's here, back from MCG, and today we're in Moonbase 9, and I'm finally back from my YouTube break and thing with the... What? Did I just miss that ladder? Oh my god, what am I doing? Okay, so yeah, I'm finally back from my break from YouTube, and my holiday, which is really fun for anyone who cared. And today I thought I'd talk about one story from my holiday, because, I don't know, I thought it was interesting, and I really don't know what to talk about in my videos anymore. So if you guys could leave it in the comments what you'd like me to talk about in my videos, like certain subjects would be nice, yeah, because I don't know what to talk about. And yeah, I just want to see what you guys are interested in, and yeah, that's a thing. So yeah, on these, so on my holidays, I went with my mom, my dad, and my friend, and I didn't know that two of my aunties and two of my uncles, that's the plural, okay. I'm joking, by the way. Never ever look in a chest ever again. Alright. He had some stuff on him. I thought it was pretty bad double tier two. But it was alright. Okay. Let's go. So yeah. What's it called? Yeah, it was it was weird. Because I didn't know that any of them were coming there, so it's kind of a shock to me. But the house was even, like, it was an even bigger shock. The house was amazing. It was right on the beach, and it was so fancy. Ah, the fanciness was real. And yeah, it was really, really nice. And of course, me and my friend were stuck with the worst room in the house, but obviously, I didn't really mind, because even that room wasn't, it was still pretty good. So I didn't, really mind. Okay. There's still more tattoos down here. On the second day on the trip, me and my friend went to, like, the shopping mall kind of thing, the plaza, whatever it's called, and we were gonna go watch a movie, but first we stopped at the coffee club, and we got nachos. The nachos were really nice. They had sour cream and the guacamole and all that stuff. Even though I don't like it, it was still nice. I don't know, sometimes just the combination of things, like, even if I don't like the individual things, the combination of them I will eat, and that's not that bad. So yeah, that's a thing, I guess. So yeah, that's that. And yeah, we went over to the cinema, and we're gonna go watch a movie, but there were really no good movies on, except for the Lego movie. If any of you know what the Lego movie is, I want to watch it, but I didn't watch it with my friend then, because I want to go watch it with all my other friends, just obviously as a joke, not like serious or anything. Yeah, that, I reckon that would be pretty fun. So yeah, we didn't go watch the movie then. And why didn't I put these on? Oh, we can make a diamond sword, didn't even notice. And yes, so we just caught a taxi home, and when we got home, I realized that I didn't get the garage keys to actually, you know, get into the house. So at that point, it was around 11 o'clock, and, what's it called? My parents were going to be back at the house by 3, so it was a 4-hour wait, and we were like, nope, we're not waiting 4 hours, and we couldn't call a taxi back to go back to the plaza, and you could have flint and steel, right? This is kind of obvious. What's it called? I want to craft my diamond sword. Whoa, let me craft my diamond sword. Did you really walk into that? Okay, I'm going to craft my diamond sword. Did I not even eat this? What is happening? Nyah. Whoa, nope, there. Alright. Let's go. Oh, good flint steel, Katie. Good flint steel. Alright. Oh, I've not been very good since I came back. Which was a couple days ago, if you guys wanted to know. No, I'm getting flipped like a pancake, leave me alone. No. Oh, that was a good shot by me. Yep, excellent. Oh, I hit him. Yes. No. Okay, I guess I'll craft another flint steel. This one's about to run out. But yeah. Whoa, he's on fire! He's on fire! This guy really has the, like, really just goes into flint steels. Like, whatever. Like, meh, it's fine. So yeah, sorry. I need to continue on with the story. Is there... Oh, no! No. Okay, so yeah, we needed a plan to get into the house, and I thought of, you get like a rubbish bin outside the house, and you get on one of those, and you try and pull yourself up on the balcony. And although that's a good idea in theory, it's a lot different in the real world. So, I could never do that. I did try, but I could never do that just because of how weak I am. Like, if you ever meet me, which you won't, you won't meet me, but if you ever did meet me, you'd see how goddamn weak I am. Like, I'm so weak. Like, imagine someone who's weak, and then I'm like under the weak level. I'm like incredibly weak. Like, what are you doing? I should lift, and I'm a girl. So yeah, I'm just really weak. So I couldn't pull myself up onto the balcony. But my friend's stronger than me, and she couldn't do it herself. So that idea just kind of went away because we couldn't pull ourselves up onto the balcony. And about 20 minutes later, like, we were still thinking, but 20 minutes later, I thought of getting the rope around the hose around the house and flinging it over the balcony, and I just need to kill someone. I'm on fire. Why is everyone on fire? Why am I lagging? Oof. Alright. So yeah, I tried to fling the hose around the railing, and then, what's it called? Fling the rose around the railing. Did I say rose? Hose around the railing, and tie it to someone, and then the other person can try and pull them up. And once again, in theory, that does work, but I am very weak, and we thought the hose was going to snap, so that idea shortly ended. So after that, we kind of waited another half an hour, and during that time, it's weird how when you're incredibly bored and there's nothing to do, you look for something. Like, your attention to everything is like, oh, whoa, there's a piece of grass over there, let's look at it because we're that bored. And at this time, we were that bored, we were just trying to find any way to get into the house. So my friend saw that almost on every window there was this this mesh, and I'm hoping it was crim safe. And I don't know, I've asked my friends about this, but if you guys know who the company Crim Safe is, their motto is, if it's not crim safe, it's not crim safe. And it's just like metal, mesh thingies that you put in front of your windows and your doors to stop burglars. And I was really hoping it was like crim safe, because she found that you could unscrew them. So we took the whole mesh thing off one of the windows right next to a door, and since the window was like, just imagine a window and then imagine stripes on that window, and every second stripe is taken out, so we could take between our shoulder and our elbow, we could fit in our arm, if that makes any sense. We tried to reach the door lock thing, but we couldn't, arms weren't long enough. So we had to find a pipe that would fit through the louvers in the window, and we did. And, what's it called? Wait, I thought I was disguised. Who is this guy? I don't know. I was about to show what you could do to find out the person, find out the disguised people. But, wait, is this disguise? It must not be. This is just a old disguise name. Well, what it looked like for an old disguise name. I don't know. Yeah, you can do a command kind of thingy to show who the disguised people are. And, the disguise function, I won't be talking about that this video or anything about disguise. But, yeah, new disguise implemented, if you guys didn't know, it's a while ago. So yeah, what's it called? I need to eat. That's what I do. Oh, whoa, no. Wait, if I kill this guy, we're going to deathmatch. So anyway, back to the story. So we got the pipe in with our hands, and we tried to get the pipe and push it and try and get the lock to twist. And we twisted it one way, and we heard a click, and we're like, oh my god, we opened the door. And then we tried to open the door, and it was locked. Whoa, my sprint just had a spaz. Oh, nope, I just want to eat my steak, my chicken. I meant chicken, but he's very close. Okay. Eat. Go. Whoa. Zoom out of there. And we hit the edge so we won't no cheat, hopefully. Anyway, And we heard it click, and we tried to open the door, and it didn't unlock. And then, I don't know why, we just kind of gave up, even though we could have just tried to flick the lock the other way, and then it would have unlocked it. But we kind of just gave up for 20 minutes, then we realized, like, oh, maybe if we just twist it the other way, then it will unlock, you know, because that's how doors work. So we did that, and it was a lot harder, just because you had to twist it towards yourself, rather than away. So it did take a bit longer, and you're eating a golden apple. Stop it. Stop it, Ron. Stop. I've been playing pretty badly since I came back from the holidays. But, yeah, we unlocked the door, and we were so happy. It was amazing. We opened the door, and we went upstairs to get a drink, and I don't know, for some reason we just picked the glasses that looked like chalices, and I was about to say, how many times is this guy going to fall for it? But he finally learned that when you eat food in Flint Steel, it's unpredictable, kind of. I don't know. Well, unless you do it like 3 times in a row like I did. I think it was 2, actually. What? Whoa. Nope. Okay, we're going to go around. And I'm seriously, my scrolling is sucking. I've been really bad lately. Okay. We just get a little bow spamming action there. Yeah, it wasn't a disguise name. It just looked like one. Okay. Just clear through this stuff. So we got glasses that look like chalices, and the only drink in the fridge was juice, and it was apple juice. And if any of you did this as a kid, also leave it in the comments if you want, of course. But it's where, like, you get, like, a glass and you put apple juice in it and you, like, kind of stir it around. Like, it's, like, really good wine or something like that. Or champagne. And you just stir it around and you act like it's alcohol. Yeah, it's just juice. I know I did that as a kid. I don't know. I kind of found it weird that we did that. We didn't do it on purpose, of course. But it just kind of came up. And, yeah. We have a lot of flint steel, so we're just going to make some more arrows. Here. Bam, bam. You don't lose any charges if you do it right, if you repair right with the flint steel. That's cool. I'm going to put all this in here. So yeah, it was a really fun holiday. And technically, I guess, we broke into a house. I mean, it was our house, of course, but we were only there for 1 day, so it's not like we inspected the house or anything like that. Yep, there we go. Wait, is there anyone else? Oh, it's just us. Alright. Alright, so yeah. Break into a house. I think that was on her bucket list, to break into a house. I know that's pretty bad. But, I mean, now she can cross it off. She doesn't have to do it, right? Right? Oh, God. I'm kidding, of course. But yeah, nope. Don't shoot me. There we go. Now I'm gonna shoot you. And we're just gonna bow you down like I did to your I don't know. Nope. I'm over here, not there. I don't think you have many arrows, and that's why he's not kind of retaliating with my bow attacks. You're just gonna keep going that way. It's kind of predictable, even though I can't hit you when I say it's predictable. God damn it. Alright, we're just going with the sword. Alright. Flint steel? Oh, he's gonna flint steel around the corner. That would've been smart of him. Okay. Oh, you get connection, I think. I don't know anymore about it. We'll just both spam to death. Alright, yeah, really good holiday, and I'll be back with my normal uploading schedule, once this video's out, and stuff like that. So if you guys enjoyed, please give a like, subscribe, and